Check it out. He has to lose 20 pounds in 2 weeks, and he already lost 8 in like 3 days. Tell me what you just told him.
I had an amateur fighter for a 165 fight. He weighed around 190 pounds, and we took 18 or 19 pounds off him in 1 day.
How do you do that? How do you lose 18 pounds in 1 day? Is that physically possible?
You don't eat, and it's all about... It's all about dehydrating yourself, you know. It is not very safe. It's not something I would recommend. And I have never done such a significant amount of weight before or since. And we're definitely monitoring this person's vital signs and making sure that their blood pressure and heart rate and everything was where it's supposed to be. And how we did it was hot baths. Once it, like, initial sweating had started, it was 10 minutes in, 10 minutes out.
Sauna? Sorry?
No, just a hot bath.
Like in the bath?
In the hot bath. And the thing about the water is, the reason you sweat is to cool yourself down. And how that happens is the water evaporates off you. So you sweat, and just being wet doesn't cool you down. It's when the water actually evaporates off you that you cool down. But when you're inside of a hot tub, you're covered in water. There's no way it's going to evaporate off you. So you profusely sweat. I find more than in a sauna or in a steam room or something like that.
And did the fighter make weight?
And he made weight, and he won the national title.
Wow, yeah. That's crazy.
Yeah, it was.
So hey, there's hope.
It was for the finals of a national tournament, and because of those stakes, we did this. Otherwise, honestly, I would have just pulled him from the fight.
It's not healthy sometimes.
It's not, and it wasn't what we wanted. Okay. He had screwed up and put on way too much weight.
So first of all, did your fighter have pants like Wally?
Nobody's got pants like Wally.
Pokemon? What is that? Pokemon?
Yep.
Wait, so I found him.
That's it.
That's it. That's the game.
So,
right?
Based on what you just said, does that mean that Chavez Jr. could beat Canelo if he can make the weight, lose all that weight?
No, last week when I was telling you, Ellie, that he will lose the weight, you know what I mean, from whatever method, scrupulous or not, that he uses. But I don't think just being gigantic is going to beat Canelo in his circumstance. It's going to help him absorb quite a beating, you know. I think, unfortunately, for Chavez Jr., and I think he'll get pummeled, you know, just the same, similar to what Sergio Martinez did a bunch of years ago.
And he almost knocked out Sergio.
True. What almost only counts, Ellie, in horseshoes or hand grenades.
Okay. So your fighter who lost 18 pounds, did that affect him at all physically afterwards? Because to lose 18 pounds in 1 day, was he alone?
This was an amateur 3-round fight, you know what I mean? It would have been completely different circumstances.
12-round championship.
Yeah, you know, there's no way it doesn't affect you.
Why did he have to lose so much weight in such a short time?
Because
normally you would work on someone weeks.
He was supposed to maintain a certain weight, and I don't know if he was trying to eat himself out of competing or whatever, you know. Fighters are quite a complex brood mentally, and he had gone way beyond the weight that he was supposed to maintain.
But you were able to fix that in 1 day.
Yeah, it was.
But you don't recommend fighters to do that. You should say you live a lifestyle where you're always around, what, 10 pounds, 15 pounds over?
10%. Okay. So be about 10% of your fighting weight going into camp, you know, preferably lower. And then how we work it, you know, every fighter is different because everybody's body reacts different. But we'll start camp around 10% over. And through the weeks of hard training and healthy, clean eating, we will have lost maybe another 2 or 3%. So now we're hovering around 6, 7%. And then we'll do some sort of hot bath or sauna.
And then they're good.
Yeah.
How much do they gain back?
Like, but some guys can't take the sauna. Like, they would rather diet down to the weight division, and we've had that as well.
But Brian, in the amateurs, don't they weigh you every day at a fight?
Like, yeah.
So what happens if he makes weight the first day, but then he balloons up? You have to do it again and again and again?
Yeah.
Wow, yeah, that sucks.
And that's typically why you'll find, like, guys like Keith Thurman in the amateurs fight at 165.
That's why.
But he's a pro 147 because you have to fight the same day you weigh in.
Sean Porter, too.
Sean Porter, yeah, a lot of guys.
I think they both, I don't know if they fought Danny Jacobs, but they were in the same division.
Yeah.
All right, there you have it, Brandon Krause. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekpak.